Ambassador Dr. Muhammad Shahid Amin Khan, Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, Assalamu alaikum and a very good evening to all. It is a pleasure to address this very esteemed gathering on the occasion of World Environment Day 2021. Let me on this opportunity congratulate Pakistan, who are hosting this year, for their achievements in the field of environment. And I thank the International Human Rights Commission. The theme of World Environment Day this year is Reimagine, Recreate, and Restore. And its focal point or theme is ecosystem restoration. Ecosystem restoration means preventing, halting, and reversing this damage to go from exploiting nature to healing it. Coming from the Maldives, one of the most low-lying island nations of the world, I am and have always been acutely aware of the threat that climate change poses to my country and our very survival. Climate change is a pressing reality for the Maldives, the Indian Ocean's picturesque archipelago comprising of 1,200 islands, with the highest point of the island nation no more than 8 feet above sea level. It is one of the most vulnerable countries in the world to the impacts of climate change, from sea level rise to more frequent and intense weather events. Environment has been an issue of huge significance in the Maldives for a number of years, and World Environment Day is colorfully marked in my country in usual times. In fact, it was the former president, Maumoon Abdul Qayyum, my father, who brought the issue of climate change to international fora for the first time in 1987 at a Commonwealth summit. Our leaders have subsequently echoed it at every international summit since. Climate change, however, isn't just a threat to Maldives alone. In the long run, no country, huge or little, wealthy or impoverished, will be immune to the effects of climate change. We have wasted far too much time and effort in recent decades debating whether climate change is real or not, even though scientists have long concluded that the climate is indeed changing, that it is real and caused by human activity. The evidence has been irrefutable for quite some time now. Today, as the world continues to be ravaged by COVID-19, we have come to understand better the intricate link between our environment, our ecosystems, and the increasing damage mankind is inflicting on our planet. We know that the frequency of pathogenic microorganisms jumping from other animals to people is increasing due to unsustainable human activities. Pandemics such as COVID-19 outbreaks are a predictable and predicted outcome of how people source and grow food, trade and consume animals, and alter environments. As per UNEP, there are a number of human-mediated factors that are most likely driving the emergence of zoonotic disease, increasing human demand for animal protein, unsustainable agricultural intensification, increased use and exploitation of wildlife, unsustainable utilization of natural resources accelerated by urbanization, land use change, and extractive industries, increased travel and transportation, and changes in food supply and climate change. Not too long ago, we had to imagine the impact of climate change. No one has to imagine it anymore. The amount of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere reached record levels in 2020. The last time carbon dioxide levels reached these levels was around 4 million years ago. The past decade was also the hottest on record. The year 2020 was more than 1.2 degrees centigrade hotter than the average year in the 19th century. the rate of ocean warming over the past decade was higher than the long-term average, and over 80% of the ocean area experienced at least one marine heat wave in 2020. These are not the record-breaking accomplishments I anticipated to witness in my lifetime. We're setting the wrong kind of records, and they're having disastrous and lasting consequences for our environment. Ecosystems all around the world are rapidly changing because of climate change, and the magnitude and frequency of extreme disasters has increased alarmingly. About three quarters of the Earth's ice-free area has been altered, primarily to supply the demand for food, raw minerals, and human settlement, and nearly 1 million species are at risk of extinction. The sensitivity and reactivity of ecosystems to climate change varies, but changes in the natural ecosystems threaten biodiversity worldwide and have implications for global food production. The restoration of ecosystems to their former grandeur on a global scale is critical to solving these challenges and keeping our consumption and production patterns in check. Ecosystem restoration is also our single most important nature-based opportunity for climate change mitigation. We can make a significant step forward for society as a whole by putting ecological restoration at the heart of how governments achieve environmental resilience and sustainability. It allows individuals from all walks of life in my country and yours to participate in efforts to prevent and adapt to climate change, and to turn a frighteningly large amorphous concept into a path towards a tangible, positive environmental action. The dangers of climate change are threatening not just us. It's threatening the fate of our future generations and the planet itself. With their futures most at stake, children and youth must be heard and their needs integrated when governments address the climate emergency. What I hope for my children is not that they inherit our mistakes tenfold as a burden to bear. We asked our children to dream big, to achieve high, and what better way than to lead by example and show what can be achieved. It has been our actions that have resulted in this crisis, and it must be our actions that will solve it too. Thank you very much. Thank you, Excellency.